we really need these innovative solutions, especially the financing solution as you propose, but I think this luxury is not available to all the entities, and especially if I talk about the private entities, it's even, you know, the opportunity is even further less. So what do you say, which is the right forum for CFOs and entities to interact so that they can come up with these new solutions where they can help each other to understand and give, you know, hand in reducing the risk, I would say managing the risk?
That's actually a very good question, and very, very humbly, I would venture to state that I think it is very important for private entities to get corporatized. Inshallah, we are working with SECP by December end to launch an SME exchange. Bombay and the National Stock Exchange in India have launched an SME exchange last month. Our plans are quite far advanced. The regulatory framework is more or less finalized. It has to go to the law ministry. But we would have an SME exchange in place by the end of the year. It would allow the smaller companies or private companies which are below 250 million rupees paid up capital to come and list themselves. That will give greater confidence to investors, market participants. And in order to make it a success, we are starting with market makers in these securities. Because without market makers, there is illiquidity, and you can already see of the 600 plus companies listed on the Karachi Stock Exchange, liquidity is only about 60, 70 companies. The rest are illiquid, so we don't want to go that route. But that is the forum. I have also created a debt market forum at the stock exchange where we have inducted some of the most senior debt market bankers, as well as investment bankers and also the SECP. And we are looking at ways where debt market trading and debt market issuance can become easy for you.
Down the back, we have another question, sir.
Assalamu alaikum, Naqib sir. My question is this, SECP or Karachi Stock Exchange, are they doing anything for options and swaps to be traded on the stock exchanges? Because it's really hard to get any kind of a valuation if they are not traded formally.
You're absolutely right. I think the problem has been slightly not so much technical in nature, but more in terms of cost. As you know, options are a fairly complex product. What we don't want to do is to start options without fully having the infrastructure and the technical mechanism electronically to be able to price and value options. If we don't do that, you're going to have another crisis where people who don't understand options start speculating on it. So what we're trying to do is to lay down the groundwork for an options program. We were speaking to NASDAQ, and they demanded 1 million euros just for consultancy services. As you know, last year, the operating loss of the exchange was about 300 million rupees, so I can't afford that. We are talking to an Indian software group, and we are hopeful that we will be able to work something out with them. SECP is supporting us. But I think that is something which is still about in the later second half of this year before I'm able to report progress on it.
I have another question here, sir.
First of all, thank you very much for a very comprehensive presentation. My question is, recently government of Pakistan has signed a currency swap agreement with China. How an enterprise, a company, could get benefit from this?
Could you speak a bit loudly? I missed the second part. Recently, the government has signed what?
Currency swap agreement with China.
Right.
So, how a company can get benefit from this agreement?
Okay. If I understand correctly, this sovereign currency swap arrangement is now becoming very, very common, especially among developing countries. And especially since euro's role as a reserve currency has come into question, and we are seeing that a lot of countries are doing currency swaps. The idea behind that is that if two countries are trading actively and their joint trade volume is, let's say, $3-4 billion equivalent, then rather than going via New York for settlement, why can't the two central banks settle in their own respective currencies in terms of the notional value of the exports and imports which come and go through each country? I personally feel that this is a very, very positive development, and it is part of China's overall strategy to make the yuan international reserve currency over the next 10 years. And I think Pakistani exporters and importers should actively participate in it. I think the State Bank is likely to put out very, very clear guidelines how you can benefit from it. But if you are an exporter to China or an importer to China, your ability to obtain yuan will become much easier if a swap is available.
And I know this. They did the very same thing in Dubai actually recently.
Yes.
And one of my other jobs, which is quite strange, is I'm doing some work with the CCTV, with the Chinese television. So maybe next time I come back, we'll keep an eye on that topic. We had another question, I believe, from a gentleman here. We have the microphone coming the other side. Super. And we've got time for maybe one or two more, so please speak now or forever hold your peace, as they say.
I'm Sajjad Hussain, from CHT Pakistan. Mr. Naqvi, in your presentation, you have given a very good example of different derivative products which can be used by the industry and commercial organization. I just want to know, all these derivative products were developed in Western countries, and when the financial crisis developed, and one of the major culprit of different reasons, these derivatives are also considered as a culprit of these financial crises. In Pakistan, do you think our industry and financial industry especially have sufficient capabilities and regulatory environment for the development of these derivative products? Thank you.
Main is pe ek thoda sa mukalma ye kehna chahta hu ke har cheez ki duras jo success hoti hai wo darmiana ravi mein hoti hai. If you take even the best product, misuse it, take it to its extreme, it will become very bad. There is nothing wrong per se in derivatives. They just, what is a derivative? It's a structured product. You take a transaction, you break it up into its various components, and you trade those components separately. That is what derivatives are, effectively. But if you take it to the extreme, it will become dangerous, because derivatives invariably will increase leverage, because you have the underlying structure and on top of it a derivative structure, and then you put something else on top of it, so you're increasing the leverage each time. So one has to be very careful, and you are absolutely right. As we develop our financial sophistication, the regulators will have to be on their toes and will have to remain one step ahead of the market. But I don't think we should just ignore derivatives, because I think they are very helpful instruments.
And I'm afraid we're going to have to wrap it up there. I do want to thank you very much, of course, for all of your questions too. I'd like to invite Mr. Abid Makbul from Fauji Fertilizer to join us on the stage. And once again, a great more round of applause and big thanks for the Managing Director, Karachi Stock Exchange, Nadeem Naqvi. And again, really pointing out alternative investment methods. When the banks let us down, please join us on stage, sir, and we'll just to present the plaque. Thank you so much. And a very, very comprehensive presentation there. And again, very interactive. Thank you all to our audience. Mr. Nadeem Naqvi, thank you so much. Mr. Makbul, thank you so much also.